Hey everyone, Shawn Pitts back again with another Grafana Quickstart. In this video, we'll be connecting Google BigQuery to Grafana Cloud to help bring those business insights, such as sales data, closer to your application and infrastructure level telemetry. Now, just like all of our data sources, the BigQuery plugin or data source is available on every tier of Grafana Cloud. Yes, even the free one, and that's exactly what we're going to be using today. Now, the Grafana docs always covers all the step-by-step stuff we'll do here, but this is just a supplemental video, so if video is your thing and reading's not, then this will be for you. So let's jump right in. Okay, so first things first, let's get this installed in Grafana. So what we're going to do is jump into Grafana Cloud. Under Connections, we'll add a new connection and toggle on Data Source. You can see that I have Google BigQuery right here, but you can search it up above and it will appear. So let's click on Google BigQuery. And in this case, you see I have two options in the right-hand corner. It's to uninstall, meaning I already have this installed, or to add it as a new data source. You'll most likely just see install in the top right-hand corner. You'll have to do that, and it'll just take a few seconds or moments, but then you should be able to add it as a new data source. We'll click on this, and you can see the data source has been added. Now comes the fun part of actually configuring the data source to make sure that we can make a secure connection from Grafana Cloud to BigQuery. Now we'll have to do some steps in the Google Cloud console to be able to make sure that it makes that connection. One of them is being that the BigQuery API has to be enabled on GCP for the data source to work. There's also two authentication versions here. So we have the Google GWT file, and then we have the GCE default service account. There's a few specific details about the GCE default service account option that you have. So if you are running a virtual machine or GCE instance, it's possible for Grafana to automatically retrieve the project ID and the authentication token from the metadata store. So you don't actually have to do that manually if you are running an instance through Google Cloud, but you'll still need to give it read access to the BigQuery API. So it's important regardless that we configure that on. Now in this tutorial, in this demo, we're gonna be using the Google JWT file upload, and we're gonna jump into Google Cloud now to do that. So now we're in the Google Cloud console, and we'll want to select our project. In this case, mine is Computer Store, and then we'll want to enable the proper APIs that are needed to be able to get set up with the data source. In the left-hand hamburger menu, you'll see that there's APIs and services, and then we're going to click on Library here. The first thing we need to make sure is that the BigQuery API is enabled. You'll see that there's 17 results. You're going to scroll down and look for the BigQuery API, and then click on that. You'll see that in this case, the API is already enabled for me. You might have to enable it, but once you do so, we're gonna have to enable one more, which is the Cloud Resource Manager API. So we'll go back into the API services library and we'll look for Cloud Resource. And then you'll see the Cloud Resource Manager API is the first result here. We'll click on this and we'll enable it. This is super important because we won't be able to actually read or get the metadata from Google Cloud. So now that we have that and we have both of those installed, we can start to worry about the service account. So we'll go into the left-hand navigation menu again and go to IAM and Admin and click on IAM. In here, you'll see that there's service accounts, and we'll need to create a service account for this enterprise data source. So we'll create a service account real quick. We'll just call this Grafana. And then you'll see that this has been created. However, we need that JWT file, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into Actions, Manage Keys, and in here we'll be able to actually add a key. This will give us our JWT file so we can upload this to Grafana to make that secure connection. We'll create a new key. We'll choose the key type to be JSON. And then you'll see that a file actually downloads onto my computer. So this is important that we have this. So now let's jump back into Grafana. And you can see in the BigQuery data source, as we scroll down, we can drop that file directly into the JWT key details. You're gonna see that it automatically fills in specific details that we need, such as the project ID, the client email, and the token URI. So now when we go to actually save and test this, you're gonna see the data source is working, which means we can explore, we can build dashboards based on this data. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right, so now that we're all configured and our data source is up and running, we can now explore and query the BigQuery data. So what's awesome about Grafana Cloud and the enterprise data source for BigQuery is that we have two options of really visualizing data here. We can do this with the builder, which you can see is just a very intuitive UI dropdown. So we can select the items that we want, such as the project, dataset, table, column aggregation, as well as filtering, group by, ordering, and so forth. But if you want to write SQL and you're an SQL pro, then we have the code editor as well. So you can see here, let's say I'm writing a from statement. We're going to notice that all of this auto-completes, and then in the bottom of this panel, we're going to see this query will process X amount of data when run. This is nice because instead of just running a big giant query and not understanding what the consequences of running such a big query is, you can look at it and say, oh wow, this is gigabytes or terabytes of data. I don't want to query all that. That's going to cost me a lot of money on the BigQuery or Google Cloud side. So that's important to note. But let's jump back into the builder and actually look at a real use case. So I have a computer store, and this is where people can just purchase simple products. So this could be GPUs, CPUs, cooling units, fans, and so forth. But I have a project, computer store, which is my Google Cloud project, which we saw, and then dataset, which is store details, and this stores all my tables. We have customer details and customer orders here. So let's say we look at customer orders, and if we get all of the columns here, you're going to see that this actually processes 6.55 KIB worth of data. We'll run this, and you'll see that we get all of my columns back along with the computer part, the price, the quantity, total order amount, and so forth. But let's say I wanted to actually visualize this to be something more useful instead of just my orders. Let's say I wanted to see what the sales or the purchases over time look like. So what we can do is we can flip this onto time series. But let's say we just tried to run this. You're going to see that it's unable to process data because it's not sorted by any time. Now, when we look back in that data, when we look at the table, you'll notice that there is a purchase date. This is an ISO formatted purchase date. So what we can do here is we can get the column, which is the purchase date, and you'll see that there is the clock indicating that this will be our time on our X axis. Now we want our Y axis. So we'll choose the total order amount. Now we'll select total order amount, and then when we run our query, you're going to see that we still get in table view. We have to toggle this format to be time series, and then we can see our purchases over time and how much the total order amount is. You can see since we're looking at this from a purchase date, we can see that on the x-axis, and then we can see the column on the y-axis, such as the total order amount. And now we can add this into a dashboard pretty straightforward. We just click Add, Add Dashboard, and then we'll open this up in a new tab. You'll see that this automatically drops it in for us, and then we can just save this as a dashboard, or we can start to add more. Let's say we want to add one more panel. We'll configure this. Maybe we go back into our BigQuery data source, and then we want to say, you know what, give us the total sales. So we're going to store details, customer orders, give me the total order amount, and aggregate this by the sum. So now, when we run this query, which you'll see it's 800 bytes, which is really nothing, we can run this query, and you're going to see that we don't get any data. That's because we don't want to use a time series. We'll want to use something like a stat. And you can see here that we have quite a bit of purchase sales. But this isn't really in a human readable format. This is going to be hard to interpret every time you come to look at it. So we'll go into the standard options on the right hand side here. And you'll see under unit, we can choose currency and dollars. So in this case, we've done $1.28 million worth of sales in the last 30 days. It's pretty good. So we can go back to the dashboard. We can actually add this in. And we can toggle this. If we want to change the layout, now in Grafana 12, we have an awesome way to do this. We have the auto grid, so we can start to change this based on if we want them wide, if we want them custom, if we want to choose the specific amount of columns. So maybe we want to do a narrow view, and then we want the row to, let's say, be tall. So now everything's a lot higher, right? And we can put these side by side. And then what's awesome about Grafana is we can have telemetry coming from different data sources. Right now, we have business data coming from BigQuery. But what if we have some sort of logging database like Loki, or if we have metrics in Prometheus? We can actually bring that in to be able to view it side by side and make correlations to be able to visualize this further. So that's a quick start on how to get up and running with the BigQuery data source for Grafana. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below, and I'll make sure to post all the docs and relevant information in the details, and can't wait to see what you guys are building. All right, I'll catch you guys in the next video.